Hi friends, today we have Rishabh Karia with us. He's one of our GATE Applied Course enrolled students. And today we want to learn your journey and your suggestions so that the next batch of students can benefit from it. Thank you, Rishabh, for taking the time.
Yeah, thank you. So my name is Rishabh Karia. I passed out in the year 2020. I did my computer engineering from Mumbai University. Right now I am working in a job.
So after you graduated in 2020,
yeah,
you have joined in a full-time job.
Yeah.
So Rishabh, what was your learning journey through the Applied GATE course? So can you shed some light on that?
Yeah, so from the Applied GATE course, the video lectures which I watched were very well structured. It covered all the topics and the concepts relevant to the GATE. And the mentorship and the support provided by the Applied GATE was very good, and the test series which they provided was very good.
In your whole learning journey, how much time were you putting in every day in your whole GATE preparation?
Roughly,
every day.
Yeah, roughly about 4 to 5 hours.
Okay. And since you're also a working professional, how did you balance your regular office work? Because you joined you graduated in sometime August 2020, and you joined in a job.
Yeah.
How do you balance that office work as a fresher with GATE preparation, especially during the critical time of GATE preparation?
Yeah, so I used to study mostly 2 hours in the, like 2 to 3 hours in the morning and 2 to 3 hours after the shift. It was about 4 hours, 4 to 5 hours.
So average 4 to 5
yeah.
hours. Okay. And what was the order of subjects that you followed, and how did you cover each of the subjects thoroughly?
Yeah, actually, so this was my second attempt for the GATE. So I gave the GATE exam in my final year also.
Okay. So in 2020.
Yeah, in 2020. So most of the topics were well prepared. So I need to brush up, revise all the topics again, and work on my weak areas. So I worked mostly on my weak areas in this time.
Very good, very good. That's a perfect strategy because wherever you're weak, you go through that first.
Yeah.
So did you go through the course videos and also solve the practice problems at the end of each section of videos? Was that the strategy that you followed?
Yeah, I watched the topics which I was weak in and tried to solve the practice questions of that.
Very good.
Yeah.
What about other topics that you already knew you were okay with? Yeah, did you solve the practice problems or completely skip?
Yeah, I directly started giving the tests on that subjects, okay, on that topic.
Subject tests directly.
Yeah.
Okay. Cool. So, in terms of your planning, because remember that you also had to go to work.
Yeah.
When did you join in your job, roughly?
September. Yeah.
Yeah. So from September, you had to both go to office or work for the office and also prepare for GATE, right?
Yeah.
So, what was your planning strategy? You said you spent 2 hours in the morning, 2 hours in the evening.
Yeah.
But was your learning mostly focused on taking tests, subject tests, topic tests, and then filling the gaps? Or were you also watching the videos for a long period of time?
Mostly it was revision and then practice, then solving the questions of the test series. And if I make any mistake or there was any conceptual error, I will go back to the videos and watch it in 2x speed.
Okay, very good, very good. Now, were you also making silly mistakes or conceptual mistakes?
Yes.
How did you rectify those silly mistakes?
Yeah,
because there are a lot of students who do so many silly mistakes that they lose a good GATE rank.
Yeah.
So how did you rectify that mistake?
So what I used to do, if any silly mistake or any conceptual error happens, I used to take a screenshot of that question and make a note of it. And while revising the subject again, I used to go to that question and revise the mistakes so it wouldn't happen again.
Okay.
Yeah.
So by when did you finish all your subjects, all the practice tests and subject tests once?
I finished revising all the subjects around November end, and after that I started giving the subject test on weekly basis, weekly or approximately 10, in the interval of 10 days. So in the interval of 10 days, I used to give all the subject tests all the subject tests, and I used to repeat it again and again till December.
Okay. And then when did you take the mock tests, grand tests, etc.?
I started giving the mock test on weekly basis every Sunday from December.
Okay. And you were still putting in those 4 hours only even during December and January?
Yeah. In weekends I could spend more time. So.
Okay. So you're trying to get the most while working also.
Yeah.
Very good. So in terms of mentorship, did you utilize the mentorship service that we provide, and to what extent did you use it?
Yes, after every mock test I used to receive calls and regarding what I did wrong and how I can improve the marks and all. Yeah,
I think you spoke to Subbarao a few times.
Yes.
Okay. And in addition to it, whenever you had some conceptual gaps, were you reaching out to the team or you didn't need that much?
I didn't need that much. I personally used to Google it out and find the answer myself.
That's always good, but because you can get the answer faster.
Yeah.
But good. So if you go back and if you have the option to change your preparation strategy, how would you change it now?
I will make better short notes of because I didn't make short notes of some of the subjects, so I will make it so it will make my revision easier and much quicker.
Okay, so short notes is something that you would correct.
I made it for few subjects, but not for all the subjects.
Okay. Yeah. They're very helpful, especially in January, when you want to revise faster. So what about any suggestions you have for students who are very similar to you, who are also working professionals? What are the suggestions for them from your, because you have experienced it firsthand, right?
Yes.
What are your suggestions for them on how to better prepare for GATE for the next year?
For the most important thing is being consistent. So we have to be consistent. We have to be consistent, like putting the daily efforts of 4 hours regularly, and even on weekends also we have to put like about 8 to 10 hours. So yeah, so being consistent is one thing, and following a good source always helps. As we have less time, so if we follow a good source of preparation, so it will always help.
So what did you mean by good source? Just to be
honest. Like the applied course,
Like the applied GATE course.
Yeah, okay.
Got it.
And online prepare, like following our online coaching will help, rather than
especially for working professionals. So any suggestions you have for the applied GATE course on how we can improve the course better for the next batch of students?
Yeah, so in the test series, actually in the last moment they mentioned that the ordering of the 1 and 2 marks questions will be changed. So yeah, that matched up my timing in the exam. So if in the next test series if we can maintain that order, shuffling of the 1 and 2 marks, it will be good.
We will surely do that. Again, that's a lesson that we also learned, because it was there in the notification and we also realized it slightly late. We will surely jumble them up.
Yeah.
We'll also give slightly trickier question papers, a few hard mock tests, few hard practice problems also, so that students are prepared for all eventualities.
Yeah.
So any questions you have for us?
No.
So you're cool with it?
Yeah.
Very good. Any suggestions you think you can think of at a later point also, please reach out to us.
Yeah.
And we'll try and incorporate as many as possible in our course.
Yeah.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.